Hi everyone, I'm Wade. By now, everyone is probably aware that COVID-19 has already caused 1.66 million deaths worldwide, and more than 70 million people have fallen ill to it. While Taiwan was incredibly successful in fighting the battle against the virus in 2020, surprising the world and gaining international praise, the latest news showed that the virus has mutated. The mutation is said to be 70% more infectious than the original strain from last year. The United Kingdom has issued a second wave of pandemic warnings, and England has entered the level 4 lockdown. Many European countries immediately closed flights to the UK. This situation is quite similar to the Spanish flu that killed at least 50 million people in 1918. Historical records show that the first wave of Spanish flu that year did not kill nearly as many as the second wave of the virus, which did the real damage. Taiwan has won the first round against COVID-19. Can we successfully fight a second or third wave while still allowing the economy to grow continuously?
And although there's considerable uncertainty, it may be up to 70% more transmissible than the old variant, the original version of the disease. So we've been informed today that in addition to spreading more quickly, it also now appears that there is some evidence that the new variant, the variant that was first identified in London and the southeast, may be associated with a higher degree of mortality.
A number of European countries stopping flights to the UK to prevent the new variant from spilling across borders.
Many people around the world couldn't spend Christmas with family last year, nor could they celebrate New Year's. But is the worst behind us? Judging from the history of the Spanish flu epidemic in 1918, the second and even the third wave of the disease caused by the emergence of a mutated virus proved to be the real killer.
Just as people were celebrating Armistice Day, there was hope that it was dying down, but then it resurged and a far more deadly and virulent strain emerged. So this second wave really spread like wildfire, affecting a third or a quarter of the population of the world.
In fact, variants of the COVID-19 have been popping up all around the world, such as on the Minx farm in Denmark and in South Africa. So, what makes the British variant so scary as to pressure London into implementing a level 4 lockdown? The government chief science advisor said that it is due to the many mutations.
Viruses mutate all the time, but the new variant contains 23 different changes, many of them associated with changes in the protein that the virus makes.
The number of people who are dying has been steadily increasing, and the most recent 7-day rolling average is over 1,000 deaths a day.
As such, this new variant of the virus has truly shocked the world. Can Taiwan prevent it from spreading? Everyone knows that Taiwan was a model of prevention during the first wave of COVID-19, as the government acquired intelligence early on and got a jump on the virus. We were able to adopt comprehensive preventative measures to allow the people to live normally while cooperating with the government in epidemic prevention efforts.
For those who receive no income during home quarantine or home isolation, we worried that it would affect the livelihood of the family. As such, there is a compensation of 1,000 NT dollars every day to allow those people in quarantine or isolation to maintain a basic living standard. Of course, while in quarantine or isolation, there is no one to take care of your meals. That's why we also provide meal delivery services. Even if someone in quarantine or isolation has a need for psychological assistance, or say their garbage at home cannot be taken out, we have provided services at all of these levels.
This past year, our preventative measures proved to be successful. However, in the face of a raging second wave of the epidemic, will our approach this year yield the same results in 2021? Will we have a vaccine? Can the current vaccine deal with the variant strains? do we have any other scientific method to effectively stop the spread of the virus?
We now have about 2,000 doses of antiviral drugs, which are very difficult to get. In fact, many countries simply cannot get them at all. We can use 2,000 doses for about 300 people. Not every infected person will get the doses. They're meant for the top 10% most severely ill patients. So, because we were able to block the first wave, we started a reserve. We have enough doses for a threshold of 3,000 patients overall. Currently, our reserve is sufficient.
In other words, we have prepared drugs for COVID-19 in 2021, but is there a vaccine? How effective is it? We need to wait and see. As people are being vaccinated, will they still need to be quarantined? We will have to wait for scientific data regarding the results of the vaccine's effect. However, one important finding has been made. We found that the number of severe influenza cases in Taiwan this past year was half that of the year before. This result shows that as long as everyone wears masks and wash their hands often, the virus can actually be controlled.
今年啊，在今年一二一月的时候，还有流感重症的病例。
We had some severe cases of influenza in January of 2020, and a few sporadic cases in February. According to our labs, from March to December, we haven't had one severe case of influenza. The lab representative said that the flu season in winter and spring can be controlled. Other than a vaccine, if we all wear masks and wash our hands frequently, we can actually prevent the spread of respiratory diseases, including COVID-19. It is true that the flu season will see more influenza cases, but the experience of some countries in the southern hemisphere combined with our experience in spring of last year confirms that if everyone wears a mask, influenza may not spread to a large degree.
Practical experience have proved that wearing masks and washing hands frequently are quite effective in preventing influenza and COVID-19. Although the new variant of COVID is rapidly spreading, our measures of preventing the first wave of the virus will continue to be applied to the second and even the third. The effectiveness of such measures may be on the same level as that of a vaccine. However, scientific proof is still needed to verify the claim. That being said, there is a chance that the success of our prevention will prove to be more effective than that of a vaccine. Therefore, Taiwan in 2021 should be as stable as it was in 2020. Finance expert and the publisher of Wealth magazine, Xie Jinghe, believes that Taiwan's economy will continue to grow this year and beyond. Since Taiwan's most recent economic development is part of a new wave of economic cycles.
In general, Taiwan's competitiveness is getting stronger and stronger. That includes this year, when we saw that in November, our exports to Europe grew substantially. It seems that this situation will not change in the coming year. The appreciation of the Taiwan dollar also allowed the country to boost its domestic consumption. Taiwan has had a very good, stable economy for a long time, so the performance of the new Taiwan dollar will raise the per capita income of Taiwanese citizens to $30,000 annually. Due to Taiwan's industrial structure, Taiwanese citizens' power as consumers will increase. This is a very important point in history for the country's economy.
Historians say that the Spanish flu of 1918 did not disappear. In fact, the virus found a way to adapt and survive in the human body. It turns out that we could not completely eradicate it. It has morphed into today's H1N1 influenza virus. Will COVID-19 follow the same pattern with the variant surviving despite human efforts to eliminate it? But we can be pretty sure that as long as we wear our mask, we wash our hands often, we can contain the spread of the virus. This type of preventative measure was our most effective weapon in successfully stopping the spread of the virus in 2020, and I believe it can continue to do the same this year. Now, I have a question for you. What is the difference between pandemic and epidemic? Do you know how to use them? Ruby, can you tell us?
Of course. I think we can agree that these two words are really alike. Not just the spelling, they are both used to describe the spread of a disease. However, they are different when it comes to the range at which they spread.
The range, do you mean if they spread across countries?
Yes. So epidemic is used to describe a disease that affects a large number of people within a community, population, or region. The Center for Disease Control further defined an epidemic as an unexpected increase in the number of disease cases in a specific geographical area. As for a pandemic, it's an epidemic that has spread to multiple countries or continents across the world. During the H1N1 pandemic, the WHO defined a pandemic as the worldwide spread of a new disease.
Okay, so am I correct in saying that the range of the spread in pandemic is larger than an epidemic, which affects a wider population?
That's correct. And there is an interesting way to memorize this. Think of the P in pandemic as passport. Pandemic is an epidemic that travels across the world, across the continents.
Ah, I see what you did there. So, how can we apply these words?
Let's take COVID-19 as an example. If you'd like to talk about how it all started, which word should you use?
Let's see. I'd say while COVID-19 was still within China, we would use the words that it's an epidemic. But once it's spread to multiple countries, it then becomes a pandemic, right?
Precisely. Unfortunately, China being one of the busiest countries in the world that sees many international travelers, the virus began to spread across the world after a short period of time and quickly develop into a pandemic, which brings us to the post-COVID world we live in.
Well, I do hope that the pandemic will end soon so that we can all get back to normal life again. For now, I am Wade.
I'm Ruby.
I hope that this episode of Knowledge was insightful and you learned some more English words. Join us at the Fun Day website to watch more.